The series of lectures, session number 8, where we are discussing all the current affairs issues. So how many of you are coming for the first time in this class? You can say yes if you are here for the first time. In this series we are discussing the money and banking, and rest of the chapters I will discuss in the upcoming sessions. How to access the previous sessions and the PowerPoint presentations? So you can see the YouTube channel, our YouTube channel. This is the link, right? And this Telegram channel, this is the link. You can join these two and you can see the previous sessions recording as well as the previous sessions PowerPoint presentations accordingly. Some ground rules about the class. You should keep giving the answer in the chat box. In fact, today I will also use the poll feature of this platform. So isme poll ka feature bhi hota hai, main usko bhi use karunga, but otherwise I will keep interacting with you. Schedule yourself for daily classes. So these classes are happening daily morning. So we decided yesterday that we will have it at 9 a.m. right? So today, because of some unavoidable reason, I have to start at 11 a.m. You have to sit with notebook and notebook and the pen. That will give you more concentration, right? The classes will happen about the current affairs, economy, GS paper 2, GS paper 3, mains current affairs. Some of the classes are already completed from GS2, GS3. We will have more classes. I will guide you about how to solve the MCQs of the prelims, how to do the mains answer writing. All these things I will guide you. So in today's class, we will discuss about the banking institution development, right? So in today's class, we will discuss about the banking institution development. So far we have completed money monetary policy, NPA, Basel norms, electronic banking related initiatives, right? So all those things we have completed so far. And in today's session, we will discuss the different aspects of banking institutions, right? So I can see Praveen Bharti, you are here coming for the first time. Okay, great. Chali, very good. Any query from the last class? Anyone having any query from the last class? So in this series, we will discuss all these things, right? So this is the question number 1, right? Please give the answer, and I will, you can see the poll. And before I move ahead, let me tell you, how many of you are using the mobile phone? So if you are using the mobile phone, use in the horizontal format. Theek hai, ye horizontal format mein aap use kijiye, then only you will be able to see the picture completely, right? If you keep it in vertical mode, then you won't be able to see the picture clearly. So you should keep in horizontal manner. This is the first thing. Pehli baat to ye hai. Second thing is, I will give you the poll option. Theek hai, to aaj main aapko poll option deta hun. So the poll will be coming on your screen, right? Aapki screen pe poll aa chuki hogi. So please click on the skip poll and you can read this question on the screen, and later on you can again start the poll. So there will be a button on the horizontal, if you see like this. So here in the right hand bottom corner, you will have a button, return to poll, right? So if you click here again, the poll will start, right? So you can carefully read the question and after that you can give the answer, right? So I can see 92% of the people, they have given the right answer. So please give the answer, everyone. Everyone, please give the answer. only 14 people have given out of 20. I want everyone to give the answer. Okay, great. So the answer in this case is option A. ठीक है जी, answer क्या है इसका? Option A है. So you can see the results. 93% people have given the right answer. Now, statement one is correct. Bank nationalization day came into existence ever since 14 banks were nationalized by the government in 1969. The first bank with Indian capital, that is a Punjab National Bank, was founded by Lala Lajpat Rai. So the answer to this question is option A, one only. Now, if we see the history of banking in India, right? So there are multiple phases. There are multiple phases. Evolutionary phase, which is basically the development of banking prior to 1947. Foundation phase from 1947 to 1968. Expansion phase. 1968 to 1984, consolidation phase from 1984 to 1990, and reformatory phase, that is which came after the 1991, right? So before the independence, after the independence, from 1947 to 1968, we were having the foundation phase. We were converting the existing bank into the nationalized bank, like SBI was converted in 1955. Right, seven princely states banks, they were converted into SBI associates in 1960. So apart from that, Banking Regulation Act in 1949, so all these developments were going on. After 1968, we realized that for the development of the agriculture sector and industrial sector, the banking sector is the backbone. But before independence, that is before 1947, this banking sector was majorly in the private hands, right? Now these private sector, their purpose is to make the profit. They want to make the profit. For making the profit, they will be giving the loans only to those people who can give them high interest and who have the credit worthiness, yani ki jinke paas mein kuch security hai aur jo high rate of interest de sakte hain, sirf unhi ko unhone loan diya, right? So loan only to the high credit worthy customer. But majority of our population was in the rural areas, practicing the agriculture sector. Farmers, small farmers, marginal farmers, they were not having any source of credit, right? So we decided that we should convert these private banks into the public banks, and these public banks should be given the target of social banking. Social banking means they will be primarily focusing upon the credit needs of the poor people, farmers, remote areas, agriculture sector, small industries. So the purpose is to provide credit to the needy people, not only to the credit worthy people. ठीक है, तो जिनको जरूरत है उनको पैसा मिले, सिर्फ जो समर्थ है उनको पैसा ना मिले. ठीक है, उनको भी मिलेगा, लेकिन जो needy people है उनको भी पैसा मिलना चाहिए. That was the purpose. And at around the same time, we also started the green revolution. हम लोगों ने green revolution भी start किया था, right? In the 1960s only. So that was also one of the reason that why we wanted to convert this private bank into the public bank, so that this public bank can provide credit to the agriculture sector and the green revolution can flourish, green revolution can succeed, right? So there were multiple reasons because of which we started the expansion phase. So the third phase started in 1968. In 1969, we did the first nationalization of bank, right? In 1980, we conducted the second nationalization of bank. So 1969 and 1980, these were the two major years in which the nationalization of banks happened. After that, in consolidation phase, nothing major was done. But in reformatory phase, when the country was facing the balance of payment crisis and the banking sector was highly regulated, what is the meaning of highly regulated? Regulation in terms of where to open the branch, when to open the branch, how many branch can be opened, branch can be opened only in the rural areas, like that. Interest rate, right? So there was huge number of restriction. The CRR rate was very high, SLR was very high. So jab hum logon ne CRR aur SLR ko discuss kiya tha, I already told you that CRR used to be as high as 15%. SLR used to be as high as 40%, 45%. So you can understand, out of the total deposit, 50 to 60% were kept in the reserve itself. So the loan giving capacity of the bank was very, very low. At this time, we constituted one committee, which is called Narasimhan Committee. This committee was constituted and this committee recommended that we should deregulate the banking sector. We should deregulate the interest rate regulation. The bank should calculate the interest as per their own method, right? So interest rate was deregulated. Bank branch expansion was relaxed, right? So the terms and conditions for opening the bank branch was reduced. The social obligations were also relaxed. The control over the CRR and SLR, basically the rate of CRR and SLR were reduced so that the loan giving capacity of the bank can be increased. So all these things have happened after 1991, and after that there has been entry of the private bank. So before 1990, private bank were not existence. After 1990, the private bank came into the picture. Public sector banks, they started facing the competition from the private sector, right? Foreign banks were also invited. So foreign bank also came. They brought the best practices. So the overall banking became the one of the competitive industry. So earlier, before 1990, the attitude of the bank officers used to be just like the attitude of the police department, which is criticized sometimes. I'm not criticizing the police department, but many a time people criticize the police department for the high-handedness. Similarly, before 1990, bank officer hona bhi matlab aapke liye bahut garv ki baat hota tha, because they were having the monopoly. But now private sector is giving the competition. You can open the bank account. There is era of payment bank, small finance bank. So right now the banking sector has actually evolved a lot. Bahut zyada evolve ho chuka hai, theek hai? Now why are we discussing all these things? Hum kyun discuss kar rahe hain? We are discussing because this nationalization, which started in 1969, the major nationalization happened in 1969. This nationalization happened in July 2019. July 1969. So in 2019, 50 years of this nationalization got completed, right? So this is a landmark year, 50 years of the nationalization of the first major category of bank has completed. That is why this becomes very, very important for your examination, right? So although this is counted as the first nationalization, but even before this, Imperial Bank was converted into State Bank of India. This was also a kind of nationalization. seven banks which were owned by the private state, they were converted into the associates of SBI. So for example, State Bank of Indore, State Bank of Travancore, right? So all these banks, they were converted into the associate bank of the SBI, and which have been actually merged into the SBI in 2017, right? 2017 mein ye merge bhi ho chuke hain. So first major nationalization exercise was done in 1969. The second was done in the 1980, right? So dono hi hue the. 1980 ka bhi is mar 40 years hai. 2020 is the 40 years. So that is why this topic becomes very very important. Ye topic bahut important ban jata hai. Even before independence, you can see the evolution. Allahabad Bank is the first bank which was under the control of Indians. Punjab National Bank is the first bank which was started with the capital of Indians, that is the Lala Lajpat Rai. Then various other banks came up between 1906 and 1913. In 1935, Reserve Bank of India was constituted as per the RBI Act 1934. So this became the central bank. Between 1913 and 1948, there were multiple bank failures, because of which in 1949 we started Banking Companies Act, and in 1949 itself the Banking Regulation Act came into force, right? So they basically constitute the regulatory laws of the bank. ठीक है, तो ये जो बैंक है वो सब यहां से रेगुलेट होते हैं. So you can see in 1955 State Bank of India, here the 14 banks and these 6 bank. July 19, 2019 is the 50 years of nationalization of the 14 commercial banks. So after 1969, the policy of India with respect to the banking changed drastically. We started focusing upon multi-agency approach, under which the loan will be given to the rural areas, to the needy people, from the side of public sector banks and other channels of the government, like cooperative bank, etc. Rural bank branches were increased. Priority sector lending was introduced, where 40% of the net bank credit is given to the agriculture, MSME and other areas, right? So under the priority sector lending, certain percentage of the total credit, that is the 40%, 40% of the credit is given, 40% of the credit is given to the priority sectors, which include agriculture, MSME, housing, education, weaker section and others also, right? Differential interest scheme was started. So as per this scheme, low interest rate to the weakest among the weakest was given, right? So these are the small schemes which can be asked in the examination. Exam mein aajkal is tarah ki scheme pooch jaati hai, theek hai na? For example, in the 2019 UPSC prelims, service area approach was asked, right? So you should have a little bit of idea about name of the scheme, purpose of the scheme. ठीक है, तो हल्का हल्का आपको idea होना चाहिए. Differential interest rate में low rate of interest will be given to the weaker section of society. Lead bank scheme was introduced in 1969, under which for each district there will be one bank, right? So for each district there will be one bank who will be integrating the efforts of all other bank also. ठीक है. There is service area approach which came in examination in 2019. Under this scheme, each bank branch, has to take care of 20 to 25 villages, right? So each bank branch will be responsible for the banking requirement of 20 to 25 bank branches. So this is about the service area approach. RRBs, regional rural banks, they were started in 1975 to provide institutional credit to the rural areas. NABARD was constituted in 1982, right? So there can even be a question. यहाँ पर question आपका इस तरह का बन सकता है that which of these four scheme was started early? ठीक है? Already in the previous year they have asked this question that which of these four event happened earliest? इन चारों में से सबसे पहले क्या हुआ था? Was it the differential interest rate or lead bank scheme or RRB or NABARD? Right? So you should know that the in the sequence lead bank is scheme was first, differential interest rate was second, RRB was third, and NABARD was fourth. So you should understand the difference between the four and the chronology of the four. So after 1991, Narasimhan Committee was constituted and it recommended many things, relaxing the banks about opening and closing the branches. Priority sector guidelines were diluted. Interest rate regulation was also diluted. After 1991, we can see this Narasimhan Committee. Then we can see foreign banks, ATMs, phone banking, net banking, digital banking, merger of SBI with its associates. So all this has happened after the 1991, right? So we are in a altogether new era as of now. अभी हम एक पूरी तरह से अलग जमाने में हैं. एक जमाना ऐसा होता था जब बैंक बहुत ज्यादा मोनोपोलिस्टिक थे, सर्विसेज बहुत ज्यादा अच्छी नहीं थी, बट नाउ द कॉम्पिटिशन इज इंक्रीजिंग एंड सर्विसेज आर ऑल्सो इंक्रीजिंग. येस्टरडे ओनली वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट यूपीआई, वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट भीम ऐप, वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट आधार एनेबल्ड पेमेंट सिस्टम, रुपे सिस्टम, एनपीसीआई, एनईएफटी, आरटीजीएस, आईएमपीएस, हमने सब कुछ कल की क्लास में डिस्कस किया था, है ना? सो ऑल दोज थिंग्स आर पॉसिबल आफ्टर इवोल्यूशन ऑफ सो मेनी ईयर्स. ठीक है, BMB is basically Bharatiya Mahila Bank. ठीक है, तो BMB basically means Bharatiya Mahila Bank. So BMB, Bharatiya Mahila Bank was also merged into the SBI. ठीक है, so the answer to this question is option A only. Next question, please give the answer. So you can just click on skip poll and you can first read the question. And after that, you can give the answer. And again, you can click and open the poll. Okay, good. So you can see the results. So most of you have given the B option only. Chaliye, let us see next question. Everyone please give the answer. Only 14 people have given the answer. I want the answer from everyone. Everyone please. You should take advantage of the session completely. Keep giving the answer. So most of you are giving the correct answer, right? So answer is B only, and most of you have given the correct answer. Very good, wonderful. So we will discuss about it. So basically there is a news about merger ke bare mein news hai. Amalgamation of the banks is happening. After the merger, 12 public sector banks will be there instead of 27 at present. The new mergers, they are happening between PNB, OBC, UBI, which will form the nation's second largest lender after SBI, right? So SBI is the first largest, and second largest will be the combination of PNB, OBC and UBI. Then Canara Bank and Syndicate Bank will merge. UBI will merge with the Andhra Bank and Corporation Bank. Indian Bank will merge with the Allahabad Bank. ठीक है, तो आपको यूपीएससी के लिए आपको नाम याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है बैंक्स का, राइट? आपको नाम याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है, बट यू शुड रिमेंबर एसबीआई विल बी द फर्स्ट लार्जेस्ट, पीएनबी विल बी द सेकंड लार्जेस्ट, एंड पीएनबी विल इंक्लूड पीएनबी, ओबीसी एंड यूबीआई, राइट? व्हाट विल बी द बेनिफिट ऑफ मर्जर? बेनिफिट क्या होगा मर्जर का? सो एज ऑफ नाउ देर आर मल्टीपल बैंक्स हैं. ऑल द बैंक्स आर ओन बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. दे आर हायरिंग द स्टाफ. दे आर ओपनिंग द ब्रांचेस इन द सेम प्लेस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, दिस इज अ स्मॉल सिटी. इन दिस स्मॉल सिटी ऑल दीज फोर बैंक्स आर हैविंग द ब्रांचेस. सो इट इज लीडिंग टू डुप्लीकेशन ऑफ द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर का डुप्लीकेशन हो रहा है, ठीक है? और इसके अलावा वी आर हैविंग स्मॉल बैंक्स. नन ऑफ आवर बैंक इज ए ग्लोबल बैंक. हमारा कोई भी बैंक ग्लोबल बैंक नहीं है. वी आर नॉट कॉम्पिटिटिव, राइट? हम इतने ज्यादा कॉम्पिटिटिव नहीं है. देर इज ए अनहेल्दी कॉम्पिटिशन गोइंग ऑन अमंग द पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंक ओनली. सो दिस अनहेल्दी कॉम्पिटिशन इज नॉट गोइंग टू बेनिफिट एनी वन, राइट? दैट इज वाई we are merging the bank so that their geographical spread and their customer base can be integrated. The cost of operation can be reduced. Standard of service can be increased. ठीक है? So for example, there are four branches. ये four branch है. एक ही city में, in a single city there are four branches. In all the four branches there will be four cashiers. चार cashier होंगे, right? But when we merge these four branches into the single branch, the work of four cashier can be done by only two people. Sirf do log cashier ka kaam kar sakte hain for all the four branches together, right? So that will save the manpower. This two manpower can be utilized for improving the banking services for the customer, for improving the products, for like reducing the cost. So this is how the merger can help in reduce the cost and improve the services of the banking sector, right? So they can go to the international standards. More and more product services can be launched. So jo do cashier free hue wo zyada product services launch kar sakte hain. I give the example of only cashier, but similarly other manpower can be freed. For example, bank managers and other staff, credit managers, wo sare staff jo hai wo aapka free ho jayega. It will improve the professional standards and the unhealthy and intense competition. So in a small city, these four branches are competing with each other for the customer, right? So that is a unhealthy competition, right? They can become part of the global market, and there are lot of interbank transactions which are happening, clearance of check, then reconciliation of account, ठीक है, तो वो सब टेंशन जो है वो खत्म हो जाएगी बिकॉज देयर विल बी ओनली सिंगल बैंक. In this case, in the recent amalgamation of three bank, Bank of Baroda, Vijaya Bank and Dena Bank, the transferee bank is Bank of Baroda, right? So the Union Bank has approved the amalgamation of three bank, that is a Bank of Baroda as a transferee bank and Vijaya Bank Dena as the transferor bank, right? So what is the meaning of transfer and transferee? So basically Vijaya and Dena Bank, they will transfer their shares, their manpower, their business to the Bank of Baroda. So Bank of Baroda is the transferee who receives all the business, customers, everything from the these two banks, and these two banks are the transferor, right? So that is why the answer is option A. In this case the answer is right. But this green channel is not in the context of banking sector. This is in the context of Competition Commission giving the fast approval for the merger and acquisitions in certain categories. ठीक है, so ये this is the term which has been used by the Competition Commission with respect to M&A, not necessarily with respect to banking sector, but it can be for non-banking sector also. Next question. Please see on your screen. I think this question is wrongly placed. So don't answer this question. Give me a second. Okay, you can answer this question. Don't worry. आप पढ़ कर लीजिए इसका आंसर को. Please read carefully and then I will start the poll. Uske baad main poll start karunga. Keep giving the answer in the poll box. Theek hai? Don't give in the chat box. In the chat box you can ask the query if you have any query. Agar aapki koi query hai to chat box mein puchiye. For answer I will be giving you the poll box. So you can see the poll on your window. So most of the answers are wrong. आपके आंसर गलत हैं. Only 16 people have given the answer. Everyone please give the answer. So the answer to this question is option B. Sorry, option A. Option A is the correct answer. ठीक है. But I didn't get correct answer. You can see only 26 people, 26% people have given the right answer. Okay, no issues. So पढ़ते हैं हम इसको. ठीक है. So the statement one and statement two are correct. We already discussed prompt correctly action framework in the NPA chapter. जब हमने NPA का chapter पढ़ा था, at the time only we discussed PCE framework. So this framework was started in 2002. So that those bank who are having poor asset quality or are undercapitalized or are having the low profitability, they can be put under some scrutiny. ठीक है. तो जिन बैंक में तीन क्राइटेरिया में है, देयर आर थ्री क्राइटेरिया. वन इज कैपिटल एडिक्वेसी रेशियो. इन केस ऑफ अर्बन कोऑपरेटिव बैंक दिस इज 9%, एनपीए 6%, एंड रिटर्न ऑन एसेट इफ इट बिकम्स नेगेटिव, दैट इज देयर आर लॉसेस फॉर टू कंसेक्यूटिव इयर्स. This fourth tier one leverage ratio is not the option, right? So only 1, 2, and 3, these are the parameter. So if capital falls below 9%, NPA rises above 6%, or there are losses for more than 2 years, then this urban cooperative bank will be put under the framework of PCA. What will be the meaning of this framework? Under this framework, the banks will be required to audit their account. They will be they cannot give the lending, and there will be many other restrictions which will be placed on the bank, right? So statement 1 and 2 are correct, statement 3 is wrong. Answer is option A, right? Now let us discuss about urban cooperative banks and the overall cooperative banking system. ठीक है. Surajit, answer is A only. Answer is A only, not D. I am very much clear about it. ठीक है. Classification of financial intermediaries. ठीक है. तो कैसे होता है and why we are discussing this topic? So we are discussing this topic because of the PMC bank crisis. So because of the PMC bank crisis, these urban cooperative banks, they have been in news. And let me show you the overall structure of the financial intermediaries in India. ठीक है. So financial intermediaries include primarily two categories of institutions, the banks and the NBFC. Right? These NBFCs, they can be regulated by the RBI or they can be regulated by the other institutions. ठीक है. उनको अलग अलग other institutions में. Surajit, can you please stop typing in the chat box? Can I complete the discussion? It is disturbing me. Okay, I will give you the option to ask your queries at the time. Please ask the queries. Okay, so NBFC and banks, these banks can be of two types: commercial bank and cooperative banks. Commercial banks means those banks which are for profit, jo profit ke liye hain. They are registered under the Companies Act and they are regulated by the RBI. So registration jo hai wo Companies Act mein hota hai aur regulation jo hota hai wo RBI dwara hota hai, right? So both are under the central government. Dono hi central government ke andar hote hain. Cooperative banks, these are the banks which are started by its members, jo iske members hote hain, and they are also the customers. They are the members as well as the customers. वो दोनों का काम करते हैं. ठीक है. They work both. Oh, you can't see. Okay. Oh, sorry. Okay, thank you. Sorry. So just see first let, take few seconds and just have an overview of this chart. So you can see financial intermediaries, bank and the NBFC. Bank can further be classified into the commercial bank and the cooperative bank. Commercial bank registered with the Companies Act and regulated by the RBI. Cooperative banks, they are the banks where members as well as customers both are same and they work on no profit, no loss system. इनका जो system होता है नो प्रॉफिट नो लॉस का होता है. कमर्शियल बैंक दे वर्क फॉर प्रॉफिट. द कमर्शियल बैंक दे वर्क फॉर प्रॉफिट. दिस इज अ मेजर डिफरेंस. कोऑपरेटिव बैंक नो प्रॉफिट नो लॉस. कमर्शियल बैंक दे वर्क फॉर प्रॉफिट. द कमर्शियल बैंक कैन फर्दर बी क्लासिफाइड इनटू पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंक्स व्हिच हैव एसबीआई एंड नॉन एसबीआई कैटेगरी. ठीक है, तो एसबीआई एक कैटेगरी हो गया. एसबीआई एंड दो अदर बैंक्स हैं जो हमने अभी देखे, दे विल बी अदर कैटेगरी. We have then private banks, ICICI, HDFC, foreign banks, Standard Chartered, American, so all those banks. Then we have differential banks, those banks which are providing their services in a special area. So these include RRB, LAB, payment banks, and small finance banks. So these are the four categories of differentiated banking. ये फोर कैटेगरीज है डिफरेंशिएटेड बैंकिंग की. तो नाउ अगेन इफ वी सी द बैंक्स व्हिच आर द रेगुलेटर ऑफ व्हिच इज रिजर्व बैंक, राइट, सो दे कैन बी फर्दर क्लासिफाइड इनटू शेड्यूल्ड एंड नॉन शेड्यूल्ड. उनको हम फिर से शेड्यूल्ड और नॉन शेड्यूल्ड में क्लासिफाई कर सकते हैं. ठीक है, शेड्यूल्ड आर फर्दर क्लासिफाइड इनटू कमर्शियल एंड कोऑपरेटिव जो हमने देखा प्रीवियस स्लाइड में. ठीक है, they are further classified into public, private, foreign and RRB. ठीक है, in fact this is the category of differential banking, right? So differential में आपका आएगा RRB, your LAB, it can be your payment bank, small finance bank, right? Like that. Public sector can again be classified into nationalized and other. Private, old versus private, new. ठीक है, तो ये आपके अलग अलग कैटेगरीज हैं. व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द शेड्यूल्ड एंड नॉन शेड्यूल्ड, वो हम देखते हैं कि शेड्यूल्ड और नॉन शेड्यूल्ड में क्या डिफरेंस होता है. ठीक है, शेड्यूल्ड बैंक्स आर दोज बैंक्स व्हिच आर लिस्टेड इन द सेकंड शेड्यूल ऑफ आरबीआई एक्ट 1934, राइट. सो दोज आर लिस्टेड इन द सेकंड शेड्यूल ऑफ द आरबीआई एक्ट 1934. नाउ व्हिच बैंक कैन बी लिस्टेड, तो ऐसा तो नहीं है कोई भी बैंक लिस्ट हो सकता है. देयर शुड बी सम टर्म्स एंड कंडीशन. कुछ टर्म्स एंड कंडीशन तो होगी तभी तो शेड्यूल होगा. सो दे आर द बैंक्स हुज मिनिमम पेड अप कैपिटल इज 5 लाख रुपीस. जिनकी मिनिमम पेड अप कैपिटल कितनी है, 5 लाख रुपीस है. व्हिच डू नॉट हार्म द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द डिपॉजिटर्स, जो डिपॉजिटर्स का इंटरेस्ट हार्म ना करे. एंड थर्ड कंडीशन इज दैट दे आर रजिस्टर्ड अंडर द कंपनीज एक्ट. वो कंपनीज एक्ट में रजिस्टर्ड है. These are the conditions. Non-scheduled banks, they are the bank which are not, which do not comply as per the rules and regulation of the RBI. ठीक है? Now, in case of CRR, in case of CRR, if we talk about CRR, scheduled banks are supposed to maintain the CRR. How much is the rate of CRR? 3%. Non-scheduled banks, they do not maintain the CRR with RBI. They can maintain with themselves. वो सिर्फ अपने पास रखते हैं. RBI को नहीं देते. In case of SLR, yes, SLR is kept both by the scheduled and non-scheduled bank. Borrowing, so scheduled bank can take the loan from the RBI, but non-scheduled bank they cannot take the loan from the RBI फॉर रेगुलर बैंकिंग, ठीक है। तो जैसे आपका रेपो होता है वगैरह होता है, तो वो सब चीजें शेड्यूल्ड बैंक के लिए होती है, नॉन शेड्यूल्ड के लिए नहीं होती, ठीक है। शेड्यूल्ड बैंक्स दे आर मेंबर ऑफ द क्लियरिंग हाउस, नॉन शेड्यूल्ड बैंक दे आर नॉट मेंबर ऑफ द क्लियरिंग हाउस। दीज आर द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन द शेड्यूल्ड एंड नॉन शेड्यूल्ड बैंक्स, राइट। सो दिस थिंग वी डिस्कस्ड हियर, शेड्यूल्ड एंड नॉन शेड्यूल्ड बैंक्स। तो नॉन शेड्यूल्ड के अंदर जो हम देखते हैं दो तरह के बैंक हैं, लोकल एरिया बैंक हैं और आपके नॉन शेड्यूल्ड अर्बन कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स हैं, ठीक है। व्हाट इज क्लियरिंग हाउस? सो माय फ्रेंड, क्लियरिंग हाउस इज बेसिकली इट इज अ फैसिलिटी विच इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द आरबीआई, वेयर द चेक्स विच आर डिपॉजिटेड from the customer of one bank to the another bank, they are cleared, ठीक है। तो आपके पास में SBI का check आपके friend ने दिया, आपने अपने PNB के account में जमा करा दिया। Your friend gave you check of the SBI and you deposited in your PNB bank. So your PNB bank can collect the money from the clearing house of the RBI, ठीक है। So ये जो check की facility होती है, check clearance की facility, ये clearing house द्वारा दी जाती है। Naveen is saying CRR is 4%. My friend, you are outdated. आप outdated हो, I am really sorry. CRR is 3%. ठीक है, CRR 3% change हो गया था in the April end, 27th of April को CRR was reduced to 3%. ठीक है, because of this COVID crisis. So all those things I have discussed already in the previous sessions. तो जो बाकी के sessions हैं वो आप YouTube पर देख सकते हो, मैंने ये सब चीजें डिस्कस की हैं, आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड। सो दोस पीपल हु आर कमिंग रेगुलरली दे ऑलरेडी नो अबाउट इट, उनको ऑलरेडी पता है। आई हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस्ड द लॉजिक बिहाइंड दैट, मैंने उसके पीछे लॉजिक भी डिस्कस किया है, ठीक है। सुराजीत, द आंसर टू योर क्वेरी, आपने पूछा कि सर ऑप्शन डी क्यों गलत है, माई ऑप्शन डी इज रॉन्ग माई फ्रेंड। आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू द ऑप्शन, दिस स्टेटमेंट 3 इज रॉन्ग, बिकॉज टीयर 1 लिवरेज रेशियो इज नॉट पार्ट ऑफ द PCE फ्रेमवर्क, राइट, इसलिए ये गलत है, राइट। दैट इज व्हाई ओनली 1 एंड 2 इज द राइट आंसर। नाउ फॉर अस व्हाट इज इंपॉर्टेंट इज कोऑपरेटिव क्रेडिट इंस्टीट्यूशंस। तो कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स होते हैं या कोऑपरेटिव क्रेडिट इंस्टीट्यूशंस होते हैं, वो कितने तरह के होते हैं और उनका क्या कैसे कैसे रेगुलेशन होता है, राइट। तो दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज ऑफ द PMC क्राइसिस, PMC क्राइसिस की वजह से ये इंपॉर्टेंट है, इसीलिए हम इसको डिस्कस कर रहे हैं, ठीक है। We are discussing because of that only, right? So these cooperative credit institutions, these can be of two type, rural, urban, ठीक है। Rural can further be classified into short term, long term. So short term and long term, it depends upon the duration of the loan which they give. तो जो लोन, अगर इफ दे आर गिविंग द लोन फॉर शॉर्ट टर्म ड्यूरेशन देन दे आर शॉर्ट टर्म स्ट्रक्चर, इफ दे आर गिविंग लोन फॉर द लॉन्ग टर्म स्ट्रक्चर देन दे आर लॉन्ग टर्म स्ट्रक्चर। लॉन्ग टर्म, अगर लॉन्ग टर्म के लिए दे रहे हैं तो लॉन्ग टर्म स्ट्रक्चर पार्ट होते हैं। शॉर्ट टर्म स्ट्रक्चर कैन फर्दर बी क्लासिफाइड इनटू 3, वन इज द स्टेट लेवल, सेकंड इज द डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल व्हिच इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज द सेंट्रल कोऑपरेटिव बैंक, थर्ड इज द प्राइमरी एग्रीकल्चरल क्रेडिट सोसाइटी PACS व्हिच आर एट द एग्रीकल्चर एट द village level. जो village level पर है, ठीक है। So they are the state level, they are the district level, they are also called as the central cooperative bank, and these are at the village level, primary agricultural credit societies. ये आपके village level पर है, ठीक है। So these are the short term credit institutions. Please understand this very very carefully because I will tell you the regulation of all of these. So main unka aapko regulation batunga ki inka regulation kis tarah se hota hai. So please understand the discussion which I am doing right now. Ye bahut important hai aapke liye, theek hai. Long term structure, this can be state cooperative agriculture and rural development bank, SCARDB, right, or it can be Primary Cooperative Agriculture and Rural Development Bank, PCARDB, right? So SCARDB or PCARDB, ठीक है? State level पे हो सकता है या प्राइमरी लेवल पे हो सकता है, या तो विलेज लेवल पे होगा या स्टेट लेवल पे होगा. दिस इज द मीनिंग. ठीक है. सो दीज आर द टू काइंड ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशंस इन द रूरल एरिया. देन वी हैव इन द अर्बन एरियाज अर्बन कोऑपरेटिव क्रेडिट इंस्टीट्यूशंस, जो सिर्फ और सिर्फ अर्बन एरियाज में ही काम करते हैं, सिर्फ और सिर्फ अर्बन एरियाज में ही काम करते हैं. ठीक है. सो कोऑपरेटिव बैंक, दे आर द फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस व्हिच आर ओन्ड एंड रन बाय देयर कस्टमर. ठीक है. जिनका ओनरशिप भी है और ऑपरेशन भी, वो सब कौन करता है? कस्टमर्स करते हैं. दे आर वर्किंग ऑन नो प्रॉफिट नो लॉस प्रिंसिपल. दे वर्क ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ वन पर्सन वन वोट. So those people who have who are the members of cooperative bank, each one of them will be having one vote, right? So they have equal voting power. They operate both in the rural area and urban area. I already told you the classification of urban and the rural. Okay, so ये मैंने आपको already बता दिया है. They can offer various services, accepting the deposit, granting the loan, and even they can give the loan to the non-members also. So please understand this very very carefully. आपके लिए बहुत जरूरी है. दे कैन गिव द लोन इवन टू द नॉन मेंबर्स. वो लोग नॉन मेंबर्स को भी लोन दे सकते हैं. ठीक है. दे कैन गिव द लोन टू द नॉन मेंबर्स आल्सो. दिस क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड इन द एग्जामिनेशन दैट वेदर कोऑपरेटिव बैंक कैन गिव द लोन टू द नॉन मेंबर्स और नॉट. यस, दे कैन गिव लोन टू द नॉन मेंबर्स आल्सो. ठीक है. नाउ दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज देयर हैव बीन लॉट ऑफ न्यूज अबाउट द रेगुलेशन ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव बैंक. ठीक है. कोऑपरेटिव बैंक के बारे में बहुत ज्यादा न्यूज रही है. दैट इज व्हाई दिस स्लाइड बिकम वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड दिस स्लाइड वेरी वेरी केयरफुली. प्लीज इस चीज को बहुत ही आराम से आप समझिए एंड देन वी विल आई विल टेल यू हाउ टू लाइक हाउ टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड अपॉन दिस और इसमें से क्या क्या इंपॉर्टेंट हो सकता है. ठीक है. सो बेसिकली इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द रेगुलेशन ऑफ द कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स, कोऑपरेटिव बैंक जो है वो रेगुलेट कैसे होती है. ठीक है. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दीज कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स वी सी इन द लीगल टर्म, अगर हम लीगल की बात करें, दे आर रजिस्टर्ड विद स्टेट गवर्नमेंट अंडर सोसाइटीज एक्ट. ठीक है. तो इन एवरी स्टेट देर इज सोसाइटीज एक्ट वेयर एनी इंस्टीट्यूशन कैन रजिस्टर. ठीक है. तो आपकी एनजीओ यहां पर रजिस्टर हो सकती है, कोऑपरेटिव बैंक रजिस्टर हो सकते हैं, राइट. सो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट इज द एजेंसी अंडर विच दे आर रजिस्टर्ड अंडर द सोसाइटीज एक्ट. अंडर द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट देर इज ए ऑफिसर कॉल्ड रजिस्ट्रार, उसको रजिस्ट्रार बोलते हैं. दिस रजिस्ट्रार इज बेसिकली taking care of the administration and management of the societies. Who can be the member, what can be the terms and conditions of member, right? How the voting will take place, how the board of management, board of directors will be decided. So, jo administration management hai, wo sab cheez kon decide karta hai? State government mein registrar. Now, second, this is a bank, right? So, it is also coming under the central bank. So the banking function होते हैं about clearing the check clear करने वाला function हो गया आपका. ठीक है. CRR, SLR वाला function हो गया आपका और बाकी जितने भी banking के fact जो functions हैं they are coming under the RBI, right? So RBI manages the RBI actually regulates in the banking aspects में ये regulate करता है. Banking Regulation Act which was enacted in 1949. This act was made applicable on these banks in 1966. ठीक है. तो Banking Regulation Act, otherwise it came into existence in 1949. I already told you in the starting of the session only. ठीक है. But this was made applicable on the cooperative banks in 1966. So you can see that these cooperative banks, they have the dual regulatory structure. इनका जो कंट्रोल है वो ड्यूअल है, एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव मैनेजमेंट विद द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड बैंकिंग एस्पेक्ट विद द आरबीआई. सो देयर रेगुलेशन इज डन बाय टू डिफरेंट एजेंसीज. नाउ इन द रिसेंट टाइम्स देयर हैव बीन मल्टीपल फ्रॉड्स, बहुत सारे फ्रॉड हो रहे हैं. द प्राइमरी वन बीइंग द पीएमसी, पंजाब एंड महाराष्ट्र कोऑपरेटिव बैंक विच इज ए अर्बन कोऑपरेटिव बैंक. सो आफ्टर दैट इट वॉज फाउंड दैट बिकॉज ऑफ ड्यूअल कंट्रोल there has been lapses इन द गवर्नेंस. तो ड्यूअल कंट्रोल की वजह से जो कंट्रोल है वो कम हो गया है एंड द फ्रॉड्स आर हैपनिंग. सो टू अवॉइड दिस काइंड ऑफ सिनेरियो इन द फ्यूचर द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट हैज चेंज्ड सर्टेन रूल्स. तो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ने कुछ रूल्स चेंज किए हैं. नाउ लेट अस सी अबाउट दैट कि क्या रूल चेंज किए हैं. सो यू कैन सी दिस बैंकिंग रेगुलेशन एक्ट ऑफ 1949 इट वाज मेड एप्लीकेबल टू द कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज ओनली इन 1966 थ्रू एन अमेंडमेंट. राइट, ड्यूअलिटी ऑफ कंट्रोल ओवर द कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स बोथ अर्बन एंड कोऑपरेटिव रूरल बिटवीन द स्टेट रजिस्ट्रार ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी एंड द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया. ठीक है, आरबीआई रेगुलेट्स एंड सुपरवाइजेस बैंकिंग फंक्शंस एंड नॉन बैंकिंग एस्पेक्ट्स लाइक रजिस्ट्रेशन, मैनेजमेंट, एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, रिक्रूटमेंट, एमलगमेशन, लिक्विडेशन, दे आर रेगुलेटेड बाय द स्टेट और सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. सो व्हाई द वर्ड सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट हियर, बिकॉज आई टोल्ड यू दीज कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स दे आर रजिस्टर्ड अंडर द सोसाइटीज एक्ट. ये सोसाइटीज एक्ट में रजिस्टर्ड होते हैं. बट there can be some cooperative banks which can operate in more than one state. There can be some cooperative bank which operate in more than one state, jo more than one state mein operate karte hain. theek hai, so they are registered under the multi state cooperative act. wo kahan pe registered hote hain? multi state cooperative और सोसाइटीज एक्ट. ठीक है, एंड अंडर दिस एक्ट द रेगुलेशन फॉल्स विद द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. राइट, सो इवन दे कैन बी रेगुलेटेड बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट बट फॉर नॉन बैंकिंग फंक्शन. द बैंकिंग फंक्शन आर कमिंग ओनली अंडर द आरबीआई. बट इफ यू टॉक अबाउट पीएससी प्राइमरी एग्रीकल्चर सोसाइटी लॉन्ग टर्म क्रेडिट कोऑपरेटिव एससीएआरडीबी एंड पीसीआरडीबी दे आर आउटसाइड द परव्यू ऑफ बैंकिंग रेगुलेशन एंड हेंस नॉट रेगुलेटेड बाय द आरबीआई. सो प्लीज सी दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग. These three structure, right? These three structure, which is the PACS, SCARDB, and PCARDB. These three are not regulated by RBI, even for the banking function. ठीक है? तो RBI इन तीन organizations को बैंकिंग फंक्शन के लिए भी रेगुलेट नहीं करता. दीज आर रेगुलेटेड एक्सक्लूसिवली बाय द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट. सो आरबीआई हैज नो रोल टू प्ले एट ऑल. कोई चेंज नहीं है. इवन नाउ ऑल्सो, इवन नाउ आफ्टर द अमेंडमेंट ऑल्सो, दीज पीएससीएस, एससीएआरडीबी एंड पीसीएआरडीबी दे आर रेगुलेटेड बाय द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट ओनली, नॉट बाय द आरबीआई. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर, यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस फैक्ट वेरी वेरी क्लियरली. ठीक है, so the same thing has been mentioned over here. Now there has been poor governance. a poor governance kyun hoti hai? theek hai, to maine bataya ki kyunki ye state government aur central government ke paas mein dual regulation hai to uski wajah se poor governance ho jati hai. now why this poor governance happens, why this poor governance happens, let me tell you. So basically, in the cooperative banks, the board of directors, in the cooperative banks, the board of directors or board of management, they are selected from the shareholders. ठीक है, they are selected from the shareholders. But in case of other banks, for example, private banks, public sector banks, the board of directors are independent. And they are not represented by the shareholder, right? So when shareholders are also the management person, there can be conflict of interest. The shareholder can manage in such a way which then benefit them personally, जो personally उनको benefit करे, ठीक है? So there can be conflict of interest. The operations may not be independent. When operations are not independent, then they can give loan to those people who can serve their vested interest, जो उनके vested interest को serve करेंगे, ठीक है? So loan to relatives, उनको loan दे सकते हैं, और they can charge less rate of interest from the relatives, or from those people who, from whom they can earn some personal benefit. So this can harm the interest of the share of the depositor. जो normal customer होते हैं उनका जो पैसा लगा हुआ है वो पैसा नुकसान में हो सकता है. And this is what happened in the PNC bank. कि PNC bank में जो management था उसने loan बहुत ही ज्यादा दे दिया DHFL को, ठीक है, और बहुत ही poor terms and condition पे दे दिया. तो DHFL का जो loan था वो that became poor, that became NPA, and because of that the PNC bank came into crisis, right? So इस तरह का जो issue होता है ये इसलिए होता है क्योंकि cooperative bank में जो board of director, board of management है, they are from the shareholder only. But in other bank, the board of management or board of director is from the is the independent. They represent the shareholder, but they are not equal to shareholder. ठीक है? Now please note this committee very very carefully. Because these urban cooperative banks have been in news, therefore this Maligaon committee can be asked in the examination. ठीक है? So you should know about this Maligaon committee. This Maligaon committee was formed with respect to the urban cooperative bank only, and it suggested that there should be the board of management in addition to the board of director, and this board of management should be doing the de facto management in the urban cooperative bank. So in the urban cooperative bank, the board of director and board of management both should be different. This board of director will be from the shareholder, and board of management, this will be the independent, jo independent hoga. In fact, BOM may be constituted from the elected member of the board, and but not more than 50% of the BOM member should be in the from the board. Theek hai? To yani ke from the shareholder which is constituting the board of director, you know, like maximum 50% member can be there in the BOM, right? So for example, main aapko example samjha deta hu cheez ko. For example, in the board of management there are 10 members. Out of these 10 members, maximum 5 members can be from the board of directors. Board of directors se maximum 5 members hi ho sakte hain. Rest 5 members will be independent. Rest 5 members will be independent in the BOM. So this will ensure that the interest of the customer and the depositors is kept above. So independent operations honge, the operation will not be done by the board of director only. Right, under all the circumstances, BOM member should have at least 2 members which are from outside the board of directors. So agar suppose these are only 2 members in the board of member, so here at least 2 members, like all the 2 members will be independent. Now what is the change kya hai? Theek hai, to humne yahan pe bataya ki fraud kyon hota hai, aur Maligaon committee ne kya bola tha. Theek hai, usse pehle humne dekha ki existing regulation kya tha, duality of control tha. कुछ एजेंसीज ऐसी हैं जहां पर रेगुलेशन नहीं होता है. नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द अमेंडमेंट, व्हाट इज द चेंज, क्या चेंज क्या हुआ. ठीक है ना, सो इन फरवरी 2020 द बैंकिंग रेगुलेशन एक्ट 1949 वाज चेंज्ड एंड द मैनेजमेंट फंक्शन ऑफ दीज 4 बैंक्स, राइट, कौन कौन से बैंक, मैनेजमेंट फंक्शन ऑफ बेसिकली स्टेट कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स, डिस्ट्रिक्ट कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स एंड अर्बन कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स, 3. प्लीज रिमेंबर कौन कौन से बैंक थे, स्टेट कोऑपरेटिव बैंक, डिस्ट्रिक्ट कोऑपरेटिव बैंक, अर्बन कोऑपरेटिव क्रेडिट इंस्टीट्यूशंस. दीज 3 इंस्टीट्यूशंस, ये जो 3 इंस्टीट्यूशंस हैं, इनका जो मैनेजमेंट फंक्शन है बट नॉट द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव फंक्शन, दैट इज अंडर द आरबीआई. ठीक है, तो मैनेजमेंट फंक्शन नॉट द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव फंक्शन इज अंडर द आरबीआई. It means what? इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? That audit will be as per the RBI norm. RBI can supersede the board in consultation with the state government if any cooperative bank is under stress. For example, it has been done in case of PMC. Appointment of CEO will be requiring the permission of the RBI. So these are the major changes. That means the management function of these 3 category of bank is now under the control of RBI. Administrative control is not under the control of RBI, that is still in the hand of the state government only. Theek hai, aur ye kyon hua tha, this was happened because of the Punjab this PMC bank crisis, this amendment will apply to all the urban cooperative banks and multi-state cooperative banks. So urban cooperative bank ho gaya, aur multi-state cooperative bank means the banks which are operating in more than one state. They are called multi-state cooperative banks. Okay. So PACS, SCARDB and PCARDB, they are still out of the Banking Regulation Act. And hence these category of banks are not registered with the insurance corporation. And hence your deposit in this category of banks are not insured. Okay. So a deposit insurance hota hai, which we will discuss after some time. The deposit insurance is available on your deposit. Earlier it was for 1 lakh rupees, now it is for 5 lakh rupees. Ab ye 5 lakh rupees ke liye hai. So this deposit insurance is available only for those banks which are coming under the Banking Regulation Act. So this is not available for these three category of bank, which is the PACS, SCARDB and PCARDB. Okay. So this question I have already discussed. So now you are asking, like some of you are asking, what is the meaning of tier 1 leverage ratio? Okay. Tier 1 leverage ratio kya hota hai? Although I have already discussed this. So leverage ratio is basically how much loan has been given, how much loan has been taken. So what is the meaning of leverage? Leverage ka matlab kya hota hai? What is the meaning of leverage? Okay, sorry, there was some problem. So leverage ka matlab kya hota hai? Leverage basically means how much like leverage is used in the context of debt to equity ratio. Debt or equity ratio ke context mein use kiya jata hai. In case of banks, this tier 1 leverage ratio basically means the tier 1 capital divided by the total assets of the bank and of balance sheet exposures. Okay. So tier 1 capital, what is the meaning of tier 1 capital? Tier 1 capital basically means the capital from the equity holders. Isko equity shareholder bolte hain, plus the reserves and balances. So equity capital plus reserves and balances, that is tier 1 capital. This capital is available for risk bearing. So if something wrong happens, NPA increases suddenly, tier 1 capital will be utilized for the first time. Sabse pehle kya utilize kiya jayega? Tier 1 capital ko utilize kiya jayega. That is why this tier 1 capital is kept at very very high in the capital adequacy ratio. Total assets, it means loans, advances and other assets including the off balance sheet exposure, the guarantees etc. which have been received by the bank. Okay. So this is the tier 1 leverage ratio. Not important for the examination point of view. Examination ke liye important nahi hai. Theek hai. So RBI has slapped restrictions on the PMC bank and appointed an administrator and superseded its board of directors. Theek hai. So because of regularities. And this primary urban cooperative bank, they can convert into the small finance bank. In case of a small finance bank, the minimum net worth will be 100 crore rupees, but it can be increased to 200 crore rupees within the 5 years from the commencement of business, right? We will discuss about it in very detail. Hum iske bare mein bahut detail mein discuss karenge about the this small finance bank, payment bank, sab kuch bahut acche se discuss karenge hum log, theek hai na? But we will discuss separately. Iske liye hum alag se separately discuss karenge. So it will take another half an hour to complete these topics. Small finance bank, payment bank, right? All the recent developments, deposit insurance. There are various other developments in the monetary policy, development banks, right? So we will discuss all these things tomorrow. Tomorrow 10 a.m. I will discuss all these things. If you have any questions so far, जो भी अब तक हमने किया, अगर वहाँ पर आपको कोई question है, तो you can ask, right? And I will ask you the questions from the homework. So how many of you have done the homework? अगर आपको कोई सवाल है, तो आप पूछ सकते हो. Or otherwise, please tell me how many of you have not done the homework. This is the time for the homework. ठीक है? Okay, good.